Yo guys, what's rocking? This BTB, and today I'm back with another fucking live narration on Docker Bitch's channel. Today we are gonna go over a fun game, or rather funny game, and this is between Germany and Europe, I guess. And I actually saw this game live, but yeah, this game is actually pretty... I don't know what to say, let's just get straight into the game. Okay, so we have Leru, who is like using this... weird bulky offense team, and he has like necrozma, which is like something, I guess. That's most likely his rock setter, because otherwise he has no rocks on his team. And the necrozma usually carries like if it's like Z move, it carries like photon geyser with the Z and the heat wave and earth power and stealth rocks. Usually it also runs like rock polish with those attacks. So like a potential move which the necrozma can have is like a thunder wave. So yeah, those are the options which the necrozma can have. But enough talking about that bitch, let's talk about the rest of the mons. He has a Bulu, most likely AV or something, or even the more popular leftovers SD Horn Leech superpower and filler move Bulu. Mega Scissor with like SD, probably U-turn or knockoff. I would say U-turn on this team with like Volt Switch on Zapdos to keep up the momentum and shit going. Probably like DD with Z move on Zygarde. Greninja, which could be Ash or Protean, hard to tell. Blackoblivion has a really fucking good team. Oblivion's team is like some cool bulky offense kind of team which I would use. It's like Mega Mawile, Tornadus. Tornadus is probably defensive because his card checks are X, so like it's probably like a defensive fucking Tornadus. Okay, so Blackoblivion leads off with the Zygarde. Okay, so if this is like a choice banded Zygarde and this is like a max special attack, max speed necrozma, then 1000 arrows should do like about 70 to 80. But if this is like defensive variant, then this 1000 arrows should do like about 50% or like a bit more. Yeah, okay, it does like 55%. So this is probably like a defensive necrozma. So, and that's probably banded Zygarde, I guess. Or yeah, this is probably banded Zygarde. I'm not even sure, but I would assume that's banded Zygarde. If I'm wrong, we'll get to know in the later period. So yeah, let's just assume this is banded Zygarde and like defensive necrozma, probably like photon geyser and shit like that. Yeah, no item revealed, so that's interesting. It could be a potential Z move, but yeah, let's see what happens in this game. So let me discuss the win cons of each player in this game. I think Leru's main win con would be the scissor if it's like SD and knock. But if it's not SD and knock, if it's like U-turn, then his main win con is the Zygarde if it's like DD. These are his two potential win cons. And Bio's win con is like if it's like Ashkrin, then that's his main win con, because Ashkrin just destroys Leru, even though he has a Bulu, but like that's easy to like weaken and stuff. He has like, even Mega Mawile is really good versus Leru. Like Mega Mawile just comes in and gets a kill if it has Fire Fang. So yeah. Okay, so the rocks are off the field, and we notice that this is a Pressure Zapdos. So Blackoblivion is free to click the fucking U-turn. So that's good for him. He gets some kind of momentum, I guess. He goes onto the Bulu as Zapdos Volt Switches, which is nice. As Leru gets to keep a momentum, he probably goes onto the Scissor now and clicks U-turn if he has it. Or if he has SD, he clicks SD. If he has Knockoff, he just clicks Knockoff. So I guess, yeah, we have like pretty basic plays here. So Leru should just click Scissor. I don't think he has like a better switch into Bulu. Unless it's like Protean Gren with Gunk Shot. A fire play would be to like go Gren and bluff a Protean if he's not Protean. But yeah, he just goes on a scissor, which is fine. That's a safe and respectable play, I guess. Now he just clicks up. I would click knockoff if I have it here. Okay, Blackoblivion stays and clicks Nature's Madness, which is a fine play. And yeah, Leru U-turns, predicting the Heatran and wanting to keep up momentum. But Blackoblivion predicts him to predict that and clicks Nature's Madness. So yeah, the chip is nice because the chip is just nice. I don't have a fucking reason for that. It's just nice. So yeah. So Leru goes on into what now? Zapdos? Yeah, probably the Zapdos. God, it's fucking almost 12 a.m. but Dockridge wants me to fucking record his games at this time, so alas, I have to do his slave work in the basement. Okay. So Leru goes on to the Greninja. Oh yeah, I just noticed this. The Greninja is probably fucking Scarf, dude. Because he has no Scarfer, so this is probably Protean Scarf. No Scarfer in such kind of a team would be like absolute fucking shit. Yeah. I think even Black Oblivion's fucking Greninja is Scarf too. Okay, Bio makes a fine play going out of Tornadus. Because in case Leru wanted to be sneaky and go for the spike, he just gets a defog off. And if he goes for the U-turn, he gets off some Rocky Helmet chip. So that was a really good play by Bio. Like a nice mid-round play. Leru just U-turns into fucking Zapdos and keeps up the world turn momentum going, I guess. Because Black Oblivion can never go into Zygarde because he has to always scout for the fucking Hidden Power Ice. So yeah. Bio getting marriage proposals in the chat. Well, that's fun, I guess. Yeah, I don't know why I'm reading the Smogtors chat, but it's open for me to read, I guess, so I'll read that shit as well. Okay, so Leru thinking about this turn. I'm not sure what he's really thinking because I don't think he has a better play other than Zapdos. Like, yeah, I don't know if he has a better play that's not Zapdos. He's probably thinking of the turns ahead, probably. But yeah, his timer is ticking down. Okay, let me try to find some interesting backstory. So yeah, if Leru wins this game, I think it's like a three-way tie between Germany East and Germany Northeast and US West. Yeah, so if Leru wins this game, then it's gonna be a three-way tie. So it's like a must-win game for Leru, I guess. And Black Oblivion's team, Europe, is already in the fucking quarterfinals, but there was some controversy in this game I really don't remember, and yeah, I don't care. So let's just enjoy the game now, I guess. So Zapdos, Leru finally clicks Zapdos after like 5,000 years of thinking, so that's nice. Now he just clicks Wolf Switch, I guess, because even if Black Oblivion goes on into Zygarde, he has to always scarf for the HP Ice. So yeah. So just click Wolf Switch, right? Wolf Switch is on the Zygarde. Oh my god, he doubles on the Zygarde to his own Zygarde. And I have no clue what that accomplished. Like, actually no clue what that accomplished. Is he like bluffing a band? What's he trying to bluff here? Is he like saying he's gonna click Outrage because there's no way he's gonna click Outrage? I don't know what that play actually accomplished though. Okay, he clicks Glare. So this is probably not banded Zygarde. I really don't know. Or it could be like banded Glare if that is set now. Week up teams have been ass, man. Yeah, week up teams have been ass as fuck. I don't know who builds most of these teams. Like, it's either fucking cheese or some bullshit offense, man. God, and the sets are so weird too. Like, I get you're trying to catch your opponent off guard, but like, oh god. So Bio should switch here, I guess, because he can't fucking touch the Tapu Bulu unless he's like Iron Tail. So yeah, Bio probably goes on into what? He goes on a Tornadus, I guess. Yeah, he goes on a Tornadus. Tornadus is pretty free, unless this is like Z Continental Crush, but nobody runs that. Okay, he goes on a Greninja. Nice double. That's a respectable double there. Now I think Bio can just stand and click U-turn. The best Leru can do is like click Ice Beam or Rock Slide here, but but Tornadus is gonna just eat that, and if Leru clicks U-turn, then Blackoblivion is gonna gain the momentum here too. So Blackoblivion's place is just fucking U-turn as he Rock Slides and gets the flinch. Wow, you should have actually Ice Beamed, my dude. If you have it, Ice Beam would have gotten your freeze there. So damn, wrong button clicked. So yeah, Bio just goes on a Mawile. Oh, this dude is about a timeout, 5 second timer. But spoilers for you guys, this guy doesn't timeout. It's a clean game. So yeah. Bio goes on a Zygarde, clicks 1000 arrows, gets a crit, and gets smacked down. Okay. The damage definitely shows that this Zygarde is banded as fuck. So this is a banded bastard with fucking glare. What are these unsets, man? Like, holy shit. Okay, Wood Hammers the Heat Run. So Bio finally gets up his rocks on turn 15. And Leru goes on to his Necrozma. And this Necrozma is slower than the Heat Run, so Bio is just free to click the fucking move. Yeah, he clicks Inferno Overdrive, so that's his Z mover. Okay. So what's the Greninja is most likely Scarf, but if he's like Ash, then Ash actually can just win at this point because the fucking Bulu is paralyzed and it's gonna keep getting fucking chipped by the rocks and stuff. So Ash has a very good chance to win if Bio is Ash. Okay, Leru goes on a Zygarde. I think he just clicks. What does he click? I don't know Leru's set, so yeah. Okay, clicks Toxic. Okay, that's really nice for him. He catches the Bulu, so that's actually fantastic for him now. I think Leru goes on into his fucking Scizor here, so if I was Bio, I would double back into Heatran here. Like, I would always double to Heatran. Okay, what does Bio do? Oh, he just natures again. Safe ass play. I guess that's fine, but you take like 12% on the Bulu. And Bulu is like your only Zygarde check, so that's kind of annoying. Maybe not really, but like that's really kind of annoying. Dude, what the fuck? Bio just threw away his Greninja. What the bloody fuck, man? Oh my god. Oh shit, I don't even fucking know how to explain this play. Oh my god, Docker bitch should kill himself for giving me this game to fucking narrate. I'm just kidding. God, oh my god. Why would he fucking sack the Greninja right there? I have no fucking clue. Like, I have actually no fucking clue, dude. Oh my god. Bio probably thought, okay, this guy's gonna click Roost. Let me stunt on him and get in this fucking Greninja and like, boom. Oh god. Yeah, Bio just play rubs the fucking Scissor. Now Leru goes on to his Zygarde. Well, just 1000 arrows, I guess. Yeah. Nice play. I mean, that's a safe play. DD was a useless play there because the Bulu is going to check the Zygarde for some more time, but getting the chip off on the Bulu is nice. Bio was actually in a fantastic position, but he just threw the game away, and I think now Leru has a chance to win, and even Bio has a chance to win still, but like, he just gave away like a 90% chance to win, or like an 80% chance to win, to like a 50-50 now. Okay. So Greninja out. Greninja is probably gonna click, what did I click here? I think Ice Beam is fine. What does he click? Ice Beam? Oh, U-turns, okay. Nice, very nice. U-turns into what? He has to U-turn into Zygarde. He has to U-turn into Zygarde and click fucking... if he's toxic, he revealed toxic, he revealed 1000 arrows. If he's DD, he goes on to Zygarde here. If he's DD, he just goes on to Zygarde and clicks DD. Okay, so what is Blackoblivion's play here? I think BO's play here is to like U-turn into Zygarde and click Glare. That's his play, I think. He knocks off, oh my god, he knocks off the Z-move Zygarde. Yeah, I think this game is over now. Yeah, this game is actually fucking over, dude. GG's in the fucking chat. Leru just DDs again here. Wait, what's the blue ad? I don't know, he should just calc it. If like a plus 2 Zygarde kills blue with 1000 arrows, he just DDs again. If it doesn't, then he 1000 arrows. But I think a plus 2 should kill from that range, because Bulu is at like, yeah, Bulu is at 39, dude. Yeah. Oh yeah, wait, does it though? What the fuck? I can't even think. Look, he's gonna U-turn here. Bulu is gonna get the grassy terrain recovery, so it's like at 39 itself. Yeah, I think he should just 1000 arrows here. 1k is the play here. Yeah. Yeah, good play. Because, that was good play. Now, BO should just go into Zygarde and click Glare, I guess. Or if he has the fucking, if he has the fucking move, what's the move called? Outrage, yeah. That dragon fucking type move. Yeah, so if he has Outrage, he just clicks Outrage, but I'm pretty damn sure he doesn't have Outrage. So he's gonna just click Glare. So yeah. Zygarde and Glare, dude, that's your only play. Bulu is a losing play here because Bulu does jack shit at fucking 39. Wait, I don't get why he didn't DD again. Probably because like hurricane damage into Woodhammer probably would have been an issue, I guess. Yeah. Right. So 1000 arrows was always the play. Wow. Okay. Yeah. BO is gonna click fucking Glare here, and Leru is gonna click DD here. Oh my god, I'm so fucking sleepy, dude. Guys, I'm so sorry for this unprofessional fucking behavior, but yeah, I'm just sleepy as fuck, and this game is actually funny as fuck too, so like, I'm somewhat motivated to like narrate this game, so that's pretty cool. Okay, DDs again on the Glare. Yep. Leru should just DD again here, because a plus 3 probably kills the Bulu, so he just DDs here, and then if he, I would say he's Z-ground, because he's like toxic DD, 1k, unless he's like fucking Z-iron tail. Okay, BO is gonna sack his Heatran here, so Zygarde is gonna click 1000 arrows here. I think BO's only play now is to like go to Bulu and hope for paras, I guess. Like he should go to Bulu and hope for the para here. And if he doesn't get it, then he has to go to Marvel and hope for the para. Those are Black Oblivion's plays. Yeah, people are saying that BO choked this game on purpose, but I think this was like, it was just a misplay on his part, to be honest. Like, people just overreact sometimes, but I think it was just a choke or just a bad play on his part. Like, he didn't do it on purpose. Like, from what I can tell, he didn't do it on purpose, but you never know. But in my opinion, he probably didn't do it on purpose. Yeah. So, yeah, whatever. Click a move, BO. Man, that Greninja sack was... Oh my god, I really don't know what to say about that. He's like, oh, let me stun on this guy, he's gonna roost, let me go into my Greninja and like fucking destroy him, but then he clicks U-turn and bop. And I think U-turn was the right play there too, because like you want to keep up momentum in case he goes Heatran, so he was always U-turning there. So like, I don't know why he clicked Greninja. Because, like, if you turn on the Heatran, then he goes on his Zygarde. Okay, cool. I'll ignore that scenario for now, unless I'll just focus on the fucking... okay, cool. He has Extreme Speed as his last move, so it's 1k, Extreme Speed, DD, and Toxic. And blows up the Z, bop. Oh my god, that's a GG. Oh my god, he gets paralyzed and he misses the plate up. Holy fucking shit, that what a fucking turn, dude. Oh my god, then hits the 1000 arrows and wins the fucking game. Oh my fucking god, dude. Oh, that last turn was hilarious. I mean, the second last turn was fucking hilarious. But because, you know what? I think if fucking Blackoblivion actually hit the player off, then he actually fucking won the game because it's a paralyzed Bulu and the fucking Grand, like... Yeah, the fucking Grand can't even fucking touch the Mawile because it's fucking Choice Scarf, dude. Like, holy fucking shit. Like, if Bio actually hit that, then he actually won. Oh my god. Oh, this game was like... I actually really enjoyed this game, even though it's fucking 12 a.m. Oh, it's 12:30 a.m. now, but yeah. So, peace out, guys. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.